So continue with more expressions. Third is time of flight. How do we define? Total time taken by a projectile to complete its motion. It is total time taken by a projectile to complete its motion. And since motion is uniform, so time of flight is equal to 2t. In the previous equation number 6, you know the value of t. So you can put 2u sin theta over g, equation number 7. Expression for height. Maximum height. Height is given by variable y, equation number 3. So you can put the value y, equation is u sin theta, use this into t, my t, small t, because in this time it reaches maximum height, minus half gt square. Use this equation, put y is equal to h u sin theta, t is u sin theta over g, minus half g u sin theta over g whole square. What you will have? U square sin square theta over g, half u square sin square theta over g. This is half of this, so h is equal to u square sin square theta over 2g. That's how you will get expression for height. Expression for range. How do we define range? It is total horizontal distance covered. Horizontal distance covered by a projectile. So that is given by x. X is equal to u cos theta into time t. So x you can put it equal to r. U cos theta into t is 2u sin theta over g. That is u square 2 sin theta cos theta by g. When you use trigonometrical formula, that is sin 2 theta over g. Right, h is here, r is there, so you can get one more relation between r and h. Divide equation 9 by equation 8. So what you will have? R over h is equal to u square. I am opening this sine to theta again. Cos theta by g. H is u square sin square theta 2g, g cancels, u square cancels, 1 sin theta cancels. What is left? 4 cos theta over What is left? R is equal to R over H is equal to 4 cot theta. So R is equal to 4H cot theta. You have got another relation. You can use one more conceptual question here. Conceptual question. For maximum range, for maximizing R, sine 2 theta should be equal to 1. This implies 2 theta is equal to pi by 2, or theta is equal to pi by 4, that is 45 degrees. So you can obtain the maximum range of projectile when you are projecting a projectile at an angle 45 degree. Actually, for this only, all players need training. Suppose some javelin throw player is there. So how during action he throw a javelin so that it makes an angle of 45 degree with the horizontal, and eventually it covers maximum range. Another thing you can observe, second concept, if we choose two angle, if theta is equal to alpha and theta is equal to 90 minus alpha, two angle, that is, then calculate R. R for this will be U square sine 2 alpha over G, R1 say. Now calculate for this angle, R2 is equal to U square sine 2 90 minus alpha by G. So when we continue with this, R2 is equal to U square sine 180 minus 2 alpha over G, that is again U square sine 2 alpha over G. What do we conclude from here? Thus, there are two angles of projection for which range covered by the projectile is same, and these two angles are alpha and 90 minus alpha, that practically means 30 degree and 60 degree, 60 degree and 30 degree, 20 degree and 70 degree, 10 degree and 90, 80 degree. Make combinations. One angle will be your 30, then another 90 minus 30, that is 60 degree. At these two angles, projectile will cover same range. Fine, so range is covered. Let's get now the velocity of projectile at any instant. Expression for velocity. Expression for velocity of projectile at any instant. How many velocity vectors are acting at any instant? U cos theta horizontally. When particle is moving up, then another vector is U sin theta minus gt. So use parallelogram. You will get resultant velocity at that instant and angle alpha. What will be the answer? V is square is equal to U sin theta minus gt whole square plus U cos theta whole square. that is u square sin square theta u square cos square theta plus g square t square minus 2u sin theta gt. Take u square common in these two terms, you will have u square plus g square t square minus 2u sin theta gt. This is velocity at any instant, right? And angle you can also find. Angle by which this velocity is inclined, that you can get tan alpha is equal to u sin theta minus gt over u cos theta. This will be the angle. Now, what happens when projectile is projected with initial velocity u and it hits back to the ground? Is the velocity remains u or it is something different? You can check it. Suppose we have thrown with initial velocity u. This is another conceptual question. When it hits the ground, time taken is 2u sin theta over g. So put it here in this equation, u square g square 4u square sin square theta over g square minus 2u sin theta. Gt is 2u sin theta over g. Fine, g square cancels, this cancels, where have you left? And this is v square. So u square plus 4u square sin square theta, that's all, minus 4u square sin square theta, this cancels. So v is equal to u. Thus, when projectile is projected with velocity u, it hits back to the ground with the same velocity. So it is following conservation law. Practically speaking, there will be a change in velocity. This case is assumed when there is no blow of air or any kind of disturbance when projectile is projected.